Honorable Chairman of this particular important session, the first plenary lecture, Professor S. A. Chahal, a dynamic Vice Chancellor of Maharana Pratap University, Agriculture University at Udaipur, where he has brought a lot of changes both in academics and administration. And also followed by Vice Chancellor of two or three universities. He is well known for his work in plant pathology with reference to wheat. And also a teacher of reputation and a person of magnanimity and with greater knowledge. I'm very happy to have on several occasions, and I take this opportunity again to have his blessings. Convener of this particular session, Dr. Rashmi Agarwal, a well-known rust pathologist, holding three important positions in IRI, besides being head of the division of plant pathology, very prestigious division for the whole country. I also see Dr. Prashant, the reporter, and many doyens and galaxy of plant pathologists. Professor C.D. Mai, Professor Pratibha Sharma, the president of IPS, Dr. P.K. Chakrabarty, member ASRB, and Professor Jalali, Dr. Saharan, and many others. Having seen all these galaxy of plant pathologists and mycologists, I remember that we have an institution at Bengaluru which is dealing with all these such kind of the post-harvest diseases. The fruition secretaries, Dr. Dinesh Singh, and as well as Dr. Devappa, who are together, and Dr. B. Srinivasulu, and many others are associated with this. But my grateful thanks to these people, and also to Gagoi, secretary. Now, I have taken up this particular aspect, biodiversity, taxonomy, conservation, and management of post diseases causing pathogens. ICR, Professor Dr. Mahamatra. Dr. Sharma mentioned that there is no such kind of section which is dealing with post-harvest diseases in this particular division of plant pathology, which is of paramount importance. I think Dr. Rashmi Agarwal, because this kind of problem is faced now almost all in every country, and it has become a major issue because the losses are more and our consideration and concentration is less on this particular aspect. So current world population may reach 10.5 billion by 2050, which further adds to global food security concerns, which is a great concern for all of us. And Professor Chahal always mentions that food security and nutritional security is very important. productivity. But only 5% of our gross income at the country level has been directed towards reducing the post-harvest losses. There is gross imbalance in the allocation of these particular grants. Now, presently, horticulture productivity of fruits and is around 227 million tons per year. Of course, Dr. Mohapatra said that is around 320, and so it includes vegetables also, that is what he said. And then by 2022, it may cross 350 million tons per year. Currently, we have 77 million tons of fruits, 150 million tons of vegetables, India wastes 16% of fruits and vegetables every year due to weak cold chain infrastructure, post-harvest diseases. These are the diseases that develop on harvested parts of the plants. Market or even before final consumption, even during storage in the refrigerator at home. Now, plant products may get infected in the field, but the disease expression, that is symptom formation, may take place later. That means during the transit or in storage, it may take place. That is an important story in the case of plant pathology. And no concern has been shown towards this particular one. Only we will see that once the produce arrives, then we will say that it is having the symptom. But during the transit and as well as during the process of marketing and other things and also harvesting, the symptom production starts and the process will start there. And not much, that is pre-initiation of symptom production is not, that has not been worked out much in our country, maybe elsewhere also. So before consumption, that is the symptoms will be seen, and such as picking, packing and transportation and storage. Now the aspects of deterioration and spoilage of fruits and vegetables and seeds also in some crops, even in the fruits also, which get infected during storage and all that, the seeds also, they get infected heavily. And their management has been grouped under market pathology. So this market pathology, in other words, post-harvest pathology, now has become market pathology because of the losses that are incurring. So economic losses caused by post-harvest diseases are enormous. This is often realized because fruits and vegetables increase, losses are manifold to the harvest and then to the consumer. And the fellow who comes to the vegetable vendor or fruit vendor who comes to the street will be going on bargaining with them for a few rupees. But how much he might have lost during the course of storage at his place, that should be taken into consideration. Unfortunately, our economy is shown only in bargaining, but not at that particular level of the vendor who is losing so much at his place of storage. So the reduction of post-harvest losses is a critical component for ensuring future global food security. So these losses are enormous, as it has been said. 16 to 20% losses are there in the case of post-harvest diseases in India, and also in other countries, it may be around 10% or maybe around 12%. Now, India annually. Reasons being the absence of food processing units, modern cold storage facilities, and callous attitude. See, during the course of transport or making them to shift from there, what they do is they use either plastic bags, the temperature will be very high. They may use gunny bags, and in the gunny bags, if you throw them into the vehicle, then there will be damage to the fruits and vegetables. And when you bring them back and keep them, there is a lot of contamination in the case of the sites where you are going to store. That I will speak later. The reasons being the absence of food processing units, modern cold storage facilities, and callous attitude. Now, post-harvest losses in West Bengal is around 13,657 crores. In Gujarat, 11,400 crores. Bihar, 10,700 crores. 10,300 crores. And in other states, we don't have much of the data. Data needs to be properly collected from all the states so as to impress upon the government and non-governmental agencies. That is how we are losing. And the policymakers like Dr. Mohapatra and Dr. Sharma and many others have to show this particular type of aspect to the government and tell them that what they have to do. Now, coming to the storage facilities, durable and perishable commodities to widespread post-harvest produce. There will be a lot of air droppings. There will be a lot of dust and so many other things also. The air droppings also, you will find number of saprophytic fungi, bacteria, which will colonize these fruits. After going into the sheds where the storage is done, there also, we don't know how long they have taken to clean that particular environment, how many times they will be cleaning every year or every month. We don't have any information on this particular aspect. And therefore, there will be a lot of inoculum that will be provided for the post-harvest losses. Non-availability of storage and transportation facilities with improper handling results in huge losses. While picking the fruits, if the damage is done, then there will be post-harvest losses. So that particular handling also should be taken into it by microorganisms, bacteria, and so on and so forth. Fungi, insects, and nematodes also in post-harvest phase, which cause rotting, decay, and decomposition. Since the nutrients are high, and moisture is high, very faster. Both quantity and quality of the produce become reduced. Now seeds also get damaged, not only in germination, but also in the accumulation of toxins, such as mycotoxins. Even in the case of fruit rot fungi and vegetable rot fungi, Aspergillus flavus is the common contaminant, Aspergillus niger is the common contaminant, Rhizopus tulipifer, Rhizopus niger is the common one, Cladosporium cladosporidis, Penicillium citrinum, and all these things they cause, and you know, some of these, they produce mycotoxins, like what that has been said as aflatoxins and aflatoxins. So proper hygiene, ventilation, and surface sterilization, using of surface sterilized containers, besides cold storage facilities, they have to be provided in the under storage godowns. Now, strategies are that application of current knowledge to improve the handling system, overcoming the socio-economic constraints, infrastructure, poor marketing systems, weak R&D capacities. See, socio-economic constraints are that properly we have to educate the vendors, we have to educate the people who are handling storage godowns, and we have to educate the people who are concerned with this particular one. And we have to see that a scientifically accurate infrastructure has to be established for the post or waste management. So that infrastructure has to be developed, and the people who are storing has to be given this particular type of infrastructure. Poor marketing system and all these things are the issues. And we don't have proper HRD, which will be handling this particular issue, post-harvest disease management. See, the students are trained in the identification of the pathogen. Students are trained in the control of the disease, but not on this particular arena. Therefore, there is a necessity of human resource development and skillful development, and the people need to be trained in this particular direction. Encouraging consolidated and vertical integration among producers and marketers. I think so far, I have not seen this kind of aspect that has been taken up. Maybe in Bangalore, that particular institute might have developed some methodologies to do this particular one. Now, fruits and vegetables, all of you know that it is a good source of many nutrients. During pandemic era, the people got affected with this particular one, or healthy people are also advised to take the lot of fruits and vegetables in the diet. And they start deteriorating immediately after harvest due to high moisture and richness of nutrients, which attract microbes, fungi, and insects. Well, fruits and vegetables consumption is important in the human dietary system, no doubt about that. But fruits and vegetables play a vital role in the farm income enhancement also, poverty alleviation, food security, and sustainable agriculture. If I am not wrong, India may be number one and number two in the fruits production. But how much wastage we are doing when we compare with Thailand, when we compare with United States, when we compare with that of South Korea, when we compare with China, that is the major issue for us. Their concentration is on the storage by means of scientific methodologies. Our storage in bulk by the farmers is not under scientific conditions. This is the major issue that needs to be tackled. So the nutrient loss includes carbohydrates, sugars, amino acids, proteins, organic acids, vitamins. There is some mistake, alkaloids of medicinal importance. And they also give us immunity also in some cases. So nutrient-rich fruits and vegetables have to be conserved, and we need a proper care from that of the post-harvest losses. And we have to protect them from all these bacteria, fungi, insects, and nematodes. Well, the symptoms that are produced in these fruits and many of the vegetables, the symptom being the manifestation of disease expression is a result of pathogen activity in the host, one has to give proper emphasis. Some pathogens produce structures like mycelium, spores, and sclerotia, pycnidia, etc., even in the storage godowns. And also while picking also you can see them. And also during transport also one can visualize on the surface of the infected parts. And these are called these signs of disease development. And there are different types of diseases antargano, soft rod, dry rod, so on and so forth. That we will show you in the table. Mostly, the symptoms in post-harvest diseases of fruits and vegetables are of necrosis type. Never you can see hypertrophy and so on and so forth, because they need living cells. Necrosis deals with the death cells, tissues that get decomposed and organs, and damage is irreversible, and all types of pathogens that I have mentioned earlier, and they cause necrosis. And these are the symptoms one can visualize. And recently, the California University people, they found out a methodology that you can collect a disease specimen. From that, you can take DNA sample, and immediately you can identify the symptom and the disease. And that is the type of technology we need in this particular country also. Now, disease diagnosis is a process of identifying the diseases through various methodologies in a sequential manner. Detection is the identification of the disease-causing agent also through any reproducible technology. First thing is visual detection. Then later on, if you want to identify the pathogen, morphotaxonomy is a reliable source. Then you can go for molecular detection, RFLP, RAPD, PCR, DNA barcoding, DNA sequencing, and so on and so forth. And serological detection, immunological methods, so many other methods are there which are costly also. But nevertheless, nowadays in every laboratory, they have these facilities. But what I emphasize is that some people, they'll be sending their produce directly to the market. So how best we can control this particular loss at the market level? So identification at the market level, how best one can emphasize the importance of the market pathology and identification of the pathogen. So all these things are to be taken care of by the researchers. Now, these are some of the diseases: anthracnose of mango, Leosporium, root rot of mango, and in the storage gardens, especially in the case of Maharashtra and Telangana, I have seen that mangoes suffer from Aspergillus niger also. And fruit rot of mango, Diplodia natalensis. And mango, as you know, that in recent times, while exporting, they have been sent back. This is because of the fact, not only pesticide residual effect, but also because of this, the colonization by these fungi and others also. And similarly, pomegranate also has been sent back, and that is also because of Aspergillus niger and residual effect. Orange rot, Sclerotium ralphii, root rot of papaya, Cladosporium herbarium, storage rot of banana, Fusarium, and Verticillium. Verticillium is only in the case of temperate regions. Java fruit rot, Leosporium sidii, fruit rot of grape, Leosporium. And then we have apple rot, Penicillium expansum, apple rot, gray mold, botrytis, and then we have got dry rot of potato, very important problem for us, Fusarium pyrulum. It is a dry rot fungus and commonly found, and it will spread under storage also. And then black rot, Aspergillus niger, banana crown rot, Colletrum musei, Fusarium roseum, cabbage soft rot, Ervenia, cabbage black rot, Xanthomonas campestris, and then carrot gray mold and vegetables also, they suffer a lot. And carrot, watery soft, Sclerotinia, and then of course, Ervenia and Pseudomonas, all these bacteria also cause a lot of rotting effects. Citrus green mold, and then citrus black rot, cauliflower brown rot, Alternaria brassicae, cucumber bacterial rot, Pseudomonas, and papaya fruit rot, Phytophthora, peach and cherry brown rot, Sclerotinia, this pomegranate black rot, Aspergillus niger, pomegranate anthracnose, Cultrotrichum black rot of Ervenia, Pseudomonas, Xanthomonas, pineapple black rot, Ileoasis, Paradaxa, potato soft rot, potato gangrene, and so on and so forth. Well, Director General has said that even spices also is a very big issue for us because it is a commodity that is getting exported to other countries. Yes, of course, Bangalore Institute has been working on this for longer time, but the spices, the storage problem is because of severity of this particular one. Because of the spices, so you don't think that they don't get infected by the fungi and bacteria. They get infected by a number of fungi, including Aspergillus flavus, then Penicillium citrinum, and Fusarium also. And all these three fungi, they produce mycotoxins. Whether it is aflatoxin, acrotoxin, or fusarial toxins, they are health hazards. And with a little bit of moisture, they produce these kind of toxins, and the deterioration is very much heavy. So the packaging materials and other such kind of materials, and as well as storage godowns, has to be taken care of. And a lot of emphasis has to be laid on the export quality of our materials, because these fungi are there in the nature, and the loss of and the absence of chlorophyll has enforced them to become either saprophytes or biotrophs or weak fungi or weak bacteria. And nevertheless, it is not their wishful thinking that they should produce the disease. So the absence of chlorophyll is with this particular group of organism made them to become the saprophytes and cause an alarming situation in the case of post-harvest diseases. But what the human mind has been doing to combat this particular disease, plant pathologies, is a serious question that is tabled by them, by these organisms, and by these fruits and vegetables before us. So it is, the answer should come from us, the plant pathologists, and the people who have been working with post-harvest diseases. And this is muskmelon, bacterial spot is by Erwinia, charcoal rot, Macrophorina faciolina, Rhizopus rot is there, Fusarium rot is there, tomato brown rot is there, tomato anthracnose is there, and like that, you can see wet rot, ghost rot, homa rot, strawberry rot, so many such kind of fruit rots and vegetable rots, and leafy vegetables suffer a lot because of, you see, these vegetable vendors and in the market and elsewhere also, they sprinkle water on their materials, and that brings out a lot of contamination through the air and various other sources. And that is how we are also consuming some of the bacteria and fungi. And fortunately, they are not jealous of us, and therefore we are free from that kind of infections. But if Aspergillus flavus is there, we don't know, but the things will be entirely different. So leafy vegetables and other vegetables suffer from different rots, such as soft rot, brown rot, bacterial rot, gray molds, brown rot, black rot, blue mold, and black mold, and caused by different species of fungi and bacteria. Now, how best we can are to be equipped with cold storage? Temperature washing, healthy packing, sanitary shipping facilities, and this requires knowledge of post-harvest technology. And then HRD is essential for this, and good ventilation is a must for us. Proper storage containers, warehouses, and avoid contaminants, and treat them with the hot water as soon as they arrive, and dry them, and then keep them in the storage godowns. Consumers demand fresh produce of physical appearance. Even if there is little bit of scale practices such as biocontrol and IPM are to be used to minimize the pesticide residue. Post-harvest handling, that is gentle harvesting and handling of harvest and cool up the day. When there is high temperature, one should not harvest the material. Only at the when the day is cool, one has to do it. And good storage facilities have to be provided. And then factors like the temperature, radiation, relative humidity, they have to be controlled in the storage godowns. And then nutrition, irrigation use, of plant growth regulators, all these things have to be taken into consideration. Grading of products, these fruits and vegetables. This is the air-cooled software and refrigeration. All these things will be accounting for our post-harvest management, careful handling of the product, treatment with lower concentration of thiobenzodiazepine, dichloride, Kapton at lower concentration. And also, some people have worked with areofungin also in India. And of course, in other countries, they don't use, but in India, they have used areofungin also. Before storing any kind of our post-harvest produce, they use this particular one so as to not to get contamination. So areofungin is used in India as a disinfectant, and formaldehyde nitrogen and nitrogen trichloride is also used as a surface sterilizer. Eradication and attenuation of established pathogen, chemical treatment, heat treatment, and of course, potatoes and other such kind of things, now they are undergoing irradiation like gamma rays, and low temperature storage and maintaining plant, that is plant breeding and disease resistance. Of course, we have
Hello, Dr. Sangeeta.
It's not audible, please.
Yes, ma'am. Yeah, it's not audible. That...
I think network.
Dr. Manohar Achari, I think network issue, he has lost the connection.
If yes, we have the number, we can call him again.
Dr. Deepa.
Yes, ma'am.
Can you check the list?
Yeah. Now, is it okay?
Yes.
Deva, you are contacting
yes.
him?
He joined.
Yes, sir, has joined back.
Am I audible?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yes, yes, yes.
Now, this. Yeah, these are the some of the sources of infection that I
share your slides.
Now, this is seed microflora. I don't
yes,
want
sir.
To
you are audible, sir. You will have to share your slide.
Yeah, yeah. So, people need.
Yes, no, it is audible. Please.
And a cross is. And fungi in storage grains are these fungi problems. It is health hazardous, and of course, gutter acquisition for aspirating, most commonly used technique for. From that are stored grains. More than 150 species of yeast and filamentous fungi have been reported on cereals, and they are represented by these fungi. And corn and gibberella ear rot is a major problem in other countries. Wheat, aspergillus, penicillium, and fusarium is a major problem. Acrotoxin, geralinium, and all these are mycotoxins, which are health hazards. These are all some of the fruits and vegetables which are infected. Banana, which that of various rots I mentioned, and then mango, colitotrichum, and then aspergillus rot, pomegranate, and then guava, and then papaya, and strawberry, apple, and grapes, and also and pineapple. And you can see vegetable rot diseases also in the market.
It's not audible, please.
Very much.
Rashmi ma'am.